This is a podcast from the Nuffield Department of Medicine. Today we speak with Dr. Olga Tosas-Auguet about her research on mapping bacterial antibiotic resistance. Hello.
Hello.
Why do we need to track bacterial antibiotic resistance?
Resistance to antibiotics is a massive issue worldwide. We know that bacteria are increasingly resistant and that this makes it difficult for infections to be treated. To put it into perspective, it has been estimated that by 2050, mortality attributed to resistant infection will almost be as much, or if not more, than cancer deaths today. So in order to tackle antibiotic resistance, we actually need to first understand where it is, so basically the burden, its distribution, and its diversity. It's sort of like asking you to switch off a fire. You first have to be given the coordinates of where the fire is and be given an understanding of how big the fire may be. So that's why we need to understand where resistance is, and we need to be able to track resistance over time.
What are the challenges of working in a resource-limited setting?
To know how much resistance there is and where it is, national and international agencies collect data. And this activity, this systematic activity, is called surveillance. So the most common form of surveillance in the case of bacterial antibiotic resistance is to get samples from hospitals, right? So just to put an example, a patient will go, we have a urine sample taken, this will be taken to the lab, analyzed, and then nationally and internationally, this data is pulled together and so that we have an understanding of where resistance is. In resource limited settings, unfortunately, most of the healthcare facilities and most of the hospitals, particularly in Africa where we're trying to do some work, don't have lab facilities. Therefore, we really literally don't know how much resistance there is and which populations are most affected by not being able to be treated by current antibiotics.
What are the most important lines of research that have developed in the past 5 or 10 years?
A very important line of research that has developed, which you will have heard about many, many times, is the ability to characterize the genetic fingerprint of any pathogen, and the fact that sequencing technologies are becoming increasingly affordable. But beyond that, even more important, or as important than that, is the fact that we can now analyze not only a single pathogen at a time, but the whole pathogen community in a single sequencing run. So what we're trying to do at the moment is take advantage of these developing technologies and try to think out of the box as to how we can increase coverage of surveillance in areas that do not have laboratory capacity.
Why does your line of research matter? Why should we put money into it?
Well, surveillance as it stands now is extremely good at helping clinicians decide what treatment they should be giving to their patients. And that is absolutely right. And building capacity in that area by building labs across low resource settings is essential. However, we argue that we also need a public health perspective, surveillance methodology that will not be useful to inform individual patient care, but can inform governments as to what areas in their nation, for example, have a problem of antibiotic resistance, or there is a threat of antibiotic resistance because we can see it from other data sources that are not the individual patient, and therefore they should be focusing their resources there. And we know that these mapping exercises can be very helpful in informing public health intervention from studies we have previously conducted in London that has given us clues. This public health perspective approach has given us clues as to where multidrug resistant organisms come from, how they are spreading, and whether they spread inside the hospitals or outside in the community alone.
Thank you very much for talking to us today.